Hello everybody and welcome back to a new drawing. This time it's an original with a deeper meaning, and this is why I'm making a voiceover again for it. Many bad things happened everywhere on the world, be it France, Germany, and many more. There's too much to list. And after that, what happened last Friday here in Germany, I really got sad, because I watched on TV what happened with my family, and it got to my heart. I was almost crying, because there could be seen how frightened the people was, and I don't understand why some people do something like that. It doesn't matter from where they come or what religion they are. I think this shouldn't be happening. This really shouldn't be happening. I mean, why should one human take another one's life? Bringing terror into the people's life isn't good. I mean, almost no one is really secure here, only a few, and I don't think it's how it should be. Everyone should be happy there where they live, and at least not with that much fear like now. So many things happened, and everywhere there's hate and fear, terror. And yeah, the most fear come from the terror, and that's really bad. I kind of feel like the world is, I don't know what to say, really. That is just not good. It really isn't good, all the bad things happening, and it shouldn't be like this. It shouldn't be like this. Of course, there always was war, and always was something terrible, but I don't know why. I don't know why it has to be like this, and I don't understand the people who doing this because of religion, because I believe in God too, and I don't think that a God that made the world like this, and human beings and animals want to kill each other. That's just, I don't wanna believe it, that it really is something that should be. I mean, sure, I don't know if it could be a world where everything is fine, nothing happens, but what's going on the latest times now, that's not okay. That's not okay. That's absolutely terrible what's happening, and I just don't get it. I don't get it, and I was like really sad on Friday, and the day after that I was like, even then I couldn't, and even now I can't believe it, what just happened here where I was born, here where I felt really secure, and now many people fear to go out alone or go with the train or something like that. Many fear that something will happen, and I don't think it's not okay. I mean, everyone lived a happy life, and now many really just sitting there and thinking, what will happen next? Will I be the next? Will someone that I love will be the next? I have to admit, I myself really scared. I'm scared that something will happen to the loved ones, or my friends that I love too, or sorry that I'm sneezing, my nose is kinda running, and yeah. And what should I say? I kind of get that idea because of all what happened, I got this idea that the world is breaking apart, and I don't think the world is really happy with it. And I don't know how, but I had this imagine in my head that Mother Earth is holding the Earth and crying over it, crying what happens here, what we do to each other. We do that to each other, and I can't understand why. I really can't understand why. I mean, you don't have to love everyone. You will always have someone that you don't like or even hate. Maybe even hate, even if it's a harsh word. Maybe you even hate someone. But to kill someone, to spread terror, it's not good. And I really think that should change. We should try to spread love, or at least, I don't know, I really don't know. I just don't know what to say, what's going on this planet, what the people do to each other. And I just had to draw this was something that really was a piece that got to my heart, that I really wanted to share with everybody. And this is the first time that I'm drawing something that has such a deep meaning, or at least I hope it has a deep meaning for me. It has, and I hope everyone can see what it means, how the Earth, how this planet where we live is crumbling apart because of us. We are not only hurting ourselves, we're hurting the Earth. We're hurting their planet, the only planet we can live, at least now. Who knows, maybe in a few hundred years or something like that, we will be on another planet. I don't know, and I don't care, because in a good 100 years I won't live anymore, and many other won't be. Everyone should try to make the best out of it, out of his life, of her life, and just try to live the way that you won't regret anything, I think. And it's hard, it's really hard to do that, but the hatred will won't come forward. It won't happen that anything good will happen with hatred. Nothing good will happen with that. And I don't see why so many people believe that this will help. War will help. Terror will help. No, it won't. The only thing that will happen is that everyone is in fear. In fear that they might be the next one to die. And this is kinda a sad voiceover, and I'm terribly sorry, but this has to be said. This just has to be said by someone. And I know I'm not big on YouTube or something like that, but I just want to say what I feel. And I'm sure many people feel like me, that it's not alright what's happening on the world. And yeah, I don't know what to say more. Maybe I should go on what I actually do. And once again, I said it wrong, I think, but it doesn't matter. I thought I would draw a girl or a woman. And as my mother, she's so cute, said, it's an angel that's crying over what's happening here on Earth, on the world. And I think that's describe it pretty well, but it could also be Mother Earth that's just crying because she's hurt. And I think everyone can interpret it like they want, as long as the message I really can't speak, I'm sorry. As long as the message comes across for everyone that something is not good, something is really going on and it's terrible what's going on here. This is my first time drawing on Earth and I hope it looks alright. And yeah, I really was on it for a few days, scanned it and made it better. Even now I can see a few mistakes, but I think it shows what I wanted, and that's the most important for me. I wanted to show you that everything is cracking, everything is hurt, not just the people. It isn't good what's happening. But again, I am coming to the bad things and I should really try to stay with the coloring process. I mixed some markers with colored pencils, the Polychromos from Faber-Castell, and I used my Sakura Jelly Roll as to make some highlights and the tears. It's the first time I'm drawing tears, so I hope it looks okay and not so bad. And also it's the first time for me doing a little complex of a background. It's the first time, and I really wanted to make that background because I felt like it has to be a background. This time I didn't feel like, no, it can be without it, I can leave it like that. I just felt, no, it has to have a background. And so I thought of a galaxy, and I have to tell you, in little it's much more easier to draw a background as galaxy as in big. I did this drawing in A4 and it took me some time, as you can see now. I started with a light rose color or pink, I don't know the exact name of the Copic. And I started with it and I was like, oh, I hope I get it right, I really hope this will look good, because this was something that I just wanted to really look good at the end, because I wanted to make the message of it clear, but I also wanted it to be not that bad, because it kinda would be sad if it would look bad. And now I'm just babbling on and I'm sorry. As you can see, I tried different methods to doing it, and at least it looks okay, I think. For my first time doing a galaxy, never in my life I did it, and I never thought I would be using Copic so much for a background, because they aren't the cheapest markers ever. But this had to be done. This just had to be done, and I knew I could make it, even if not the masterpiece of galaxies, but I think it's okay. And yeah, I hope it has the effect that I want, that this has some meaning, this has some deep meaning, this drawing, and I hope someday everything will be alright. Everything will be alright, and that nothing even more bad happens. And I really, really, really hope that there will be no war, because this would be the terriblest thing ever. And as you can see, I'm trying to make the corners a little darker, and later on I will make it even more darker, because I kind of felt like it lightened up because of the blue, and I wanted it to be a little more dark. And I tried around a little bit till I really was satisfied with the background, Oh, I'm sometimes really just have to make it really good, because if I'm not doing it, then I don't feel satisfied with the picture. And I tried and tried and then showed my mother, and she was like, "Oh, what's the pink bubbles there?" And I was like, yeah, it doesn't look so good. Oh, should I draw them over?" She, yeah, I think that would be better." And I was like, "Okay, thank you, ma'am." Then I got back to my room and colored over them. Then I thought, "No, that doesn't look good." And then I took the gray, dark gray marker and colored over it. Then it kinda looked okay. So with the stars later on, it looks even better, I think. As I said, it's my first time doing a galaxy. I think if I would do this more often, but if I do, I really will using a smaller paper. This A4 paper is really big, and I need the money to buy refills, because refills, I don't know how to say this, for the Copic markers, that you can refill them. So I think refill is right. And again, I'm babbling on and I'm so sorry. As you can see now, I'm making the stars, and somehow I really had fun doing them, because I just had to do little dots. Then I made a few little stars stand out, and yeah, and then I used a white colored pencil and made them even more to stand out, and made a shine around her and the earth. I hope if I scan it, it will be seen, or even better than now. And I had much work with it, but I kind of feel like it was worth it. I really like it, and it seems that some that are already seen this get the meaning of it, and that's what was my purpose. I really wanted it to give a message that everyone can understand. And yeah, that's it. That's the video, and thank you for watching. Thanks for hearing my babbling, and see you next time. If you want to help me, subscribe, like, share, and see you in the next video. Bye bye!